Everyone, this is your friend SG, and in today's video we'll be covering React interview questions related to JSX. So this is the third video of our series. If you haven't watched the previous parts where we covered virtual DOM and the basic React questions, go check out the links. You can find the link in I button or in the description. Okay, so check out the previous videos as well. They are awesome. You will get to learn a lot about them, about all the concepts of React. Okay, so let's just begin the video. Okay, so JSX. So the very first question could be, what is JSX? So JSX stands for JavaScript XML. It allows us to write HTML code in React. It allows us to write HTML elements in JavaScript and place them in the DOM without any create element or append child methods. Okay, so if we were writing the code in React, what we have written, it could be react.create element. Then inside that we'll have to write create an unordered list and give it a ID of nav, and then again inside that we'll have to create a element list item, and inside that we'll have to create anchor tags. So react.create element again with href as hash, no link, and value as home. So this is a very complicated code, a lot of nesting is done. So in create element ul, inside that again created an element list item, inside that again created an anchor tag. Okay, but so a lot of nesting is done. But what if we were using JSX? So JSX code is this much only. We'll have to directly write the code like HTML. Okay, so if you see, you could say that this code is only HTML. What is the difference between JSX and HTML? The main difference comes in the form of the working, and the HTML code, it was written in the .html file. But this code, this JSX code, it will be written inside a JavaScript file. Okay, so you might say that it looks similar to HTML, but it's not. Just key. Get this thing in your mind that this is nothing like HTML. Okay, JSX converts HTML tags into React elements. It may look like HTML, but in working it is nothing like HTML. It is nothing like HTML. Keep this thing in mind. Okay, I'm constantly repeating this word. It is nothing like HTML. Okay, this is a very important line. So the next question comes, can web browsers directly read JSX? What will be the answer and why? Explain that. So web browsers cannot read JSX. Browsers can only read JavaScript objects, but JSX is not a regular JavaScript object. So to enable a browser to read JSX, we need to transform the JSX file into a JavaScript object using JSX transformers. So the answer to our question is no, web browsers cannot read JSX. Then how that JSX is rendered on the browser? So what happens is that JSX is converted into a JavaScript readable object. Okay. Or the browsers, they are only able to read JavaScript. So that JSX is converted to JavaScript, and that JavaScript is read by the browsers. And so they update the anything that we see on the browser. So they update the browser. Now this transformation, this is done from JSX to JavaScript object. This is done using a transcompiler. Okay. So what is a transcompiler? You can say transcompiler is a tool that could be used to convert one form of code into the another. It's used to convert one form of code into another. Here we convert JSX into the JS code. The most famous example of transcompiler is Babel, which is also used in React. So if you had seen the very first video of our series, we saw that using create React app, we get a lot of things, and one of them is Babel file as well. So now we got to know what actually Babel is. It is a transcompiler. Okay. So let's just dive deep into what is Babel. So Babel is a transcompiler that is mainly used to convert ECMAScript 2015 plus code, that is AS6 plus code, into the backward compatible version of JavaScript that can be run by older JavaScript engines as well. Okay, so there are a lot of older browsers which are not compatible with the new versions of JavaScript. So it is a very common thing that if they are not compatible with new versions of JavaScript, how will they be compatible with React? So they won't be able to understand JavaScript. So in order to do that, Babel comes into use. It converts the latest or ES6 plus code into the backward compatible JavaScript code. Okay, so that it could be read by all the engines. In React, Babel is used to convert the JSX into JavaScript, which could easily be read by the browsers. Okay, so this is the use of Babel. And how the things work? So initially we had JSX. Now this JSX is transcompiled using Babel into a JavaScript object. Now that JavaScript object updates the virtual DOM. Virtual DOM further updates the actual DOM, and that DOM renders all the changes to the browser. Okay, so this is the entire working of Babel. From JSX, we got JS code. That JS code updated the DOM, and that DOM updated the browser. So if you want to get to know all the working of virtual DOM, DOM and how things work, you can watch the previous video. I explained everything in detail. Okay. So this is for this video. We understood everything about JSX, Babel, transcompiler, and now we have a deep understanding how things are working behind in React, how everything is working, how that code is rendered on the browser, how browser manipulates it and then re-renders again on the to everything that is visible to us, how it is re-rendered again. Okay, so this is it. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comments below or you can join my Telegram group as well. Thank you. Tata. Bye-bye.